The Great Crusade. Ritter was sitting on a sidewalk, his head fucked between his knees, staring at the floor. He felt lonely. He had just lost his job for a few weeks and his rent was late. The bills were piling up and he could no longer honor them. His life seemed hopeless, he was crushing black. He believed that there was no solution. The wind blew a white feather against his feet. He gazed at the featureless feet at first on board, until he found it pretty. He lives in this feather life in all its beauty. He finally got up and leaned on his arms, without much conviction, but he knew he had to get up from where he had fallen. Staying on the sidewalk watching the dust passed under his eyes would not help him. He should get up and take a walk. Hardly, he straightened up, putting his hat on his head and turned to face the trade that was making his back. It was a convenience store. He looked at the hollow belly trade. Not having a penny in his pocket, he turned away his vision of the trade and wondered if he was going to his home or just going for a walk. Take a walk. While walking on this great artery, he saw the crowd coming and going. Even in the midst of this crowd, he felt lonely and isolated. He did not know what to do. He continued to walk slowly, advancing step by step and looking around him. He saw people, in good faith, walking around with bags full of food and fireworks. He did not even have a penny. Without even envying them, he hoped to make his destiny better. The path of his home. Deciding finally to go home, Ritter dragged his feet to his apartment. He sat down in his favorite chair, stared at the pile of bills and opened the last beer he had left in the fridge. While sipping his beer, he took the newspaper under the bills. Flipping through the pages without aim, he saw an advertisement offering a job that he considered interesting. It was not the job of his dreams, but at least he would have an income. It was a day job as a shovel. Winter was coming with its first flakes of snow. That morning, a thin white carpet covered the floor. Ritter was holding a coffee in his hand and was eager to start his new job. Ritter had been without financial resources for a long time, when a good snowstorm was coming. It seemed to allay his worries. Ritter now had a job. This ensured him financial security. However, his old life was missing. The luxury he had known in the past seemed to be nothing but a memory. The luxury for Ritter was in fact having a roof over his head, food, and sometimes partying. He had never missed anything and he had never faced any failure. He had just lost a job he loved. The day he was sitting on the sidewalk looking at the stolen dust around him, he had just lost an engineering job. His life suddenly shifted to the unknown. He felt a multitude of feelings, such as sadness, pain, and even anger. He was furious at losing his job because of budget cuts. Ritter had not hesitated to roll up his sleeves to find a solution to his financial problems. The finances were not the best, but it allowed him to support himself. Loneliness was hard to live. Despite his poor financial means, he decided to save some money for a Friday night out. That Friday, Ritter went to his apartment after work. He went to take a shower and put on his best clothes. He put his hat on his head and went out of his house towards the small neighborhood bar. It was still early in the evening and the bar was almost empty. A group of men were having a beer by the pool table, while a few others were sitting at the bar. Billiards. Ritter went to the bar and took a drink. While waiting for his drink, he looked around him. Those who played billiards had just lost a player. One of the men called out to ask him to play billiards with them. Shy but happy, he went to join the group. The woman who stood at the bar and who had not so much attracted Ritter's attention joined them. She was tired of being alone and wanted company. Bravina initiated the conversation with Ritter. She simply asked him if he used to come to this bar. She was the first time she showed up. Bravina was a young woman in her early 30s. That night, she decided to go out to break the loneliness. Without waiting, she had come to this bar in order to make new acquaintances. The woman at the bar. He took his courage and ordered two beers. The barmaid offered a drink to the woman who was standing by her side. She accepted it and turned to Ritter, offering him the most wonderful smile. Ritter was stunned by this spontaneous reaction. It made him warm to the heart. A burst of heat invaded him. Her cheeks became scarlet. Keeping control of himself, he introduced himself to Bravina, the woman with long blonde hair. Earthquake. Ritter and Bravina met each other. Sparks illuminated their eyes. Ritter approached Bravina and took her by the hand. The earth began to shake suddenly. Panicking, Bravina hugged Ritter. Huddled together, they closed their eyes for a moment. The bar door opened suddenly and the wind blew on everyone. They felt the wind beating down on them with violence, but they could not help it. Bravina opened his eyes and saw stolen shadows around them. Suddenly there was nothing left. Calm seemed to return. Something had, however, marked that moment. He had known the union Ritter and Bravina. Ritter and Bravina. Bravina had grown up in a poor environment, but how much filled with love. Only, his mother being the only parent was obliged to leave regularly for work. The young woman had to get educated almost by herself. Far from being the image of wisdom, she touched delinquency and the dark side of life. She was a light-hearted girl who accumulated the number of male partners without conscience. Not very respectful of the moral, civil, and religious laws, she was expatriated. A backpack on the shoulder for only luggage, she left her counted to join the big city. Ritter came from a noble family, but not from the heart. His parents always looked after him, but insidiously, it was always to keep him close to them and isolated from the whole world. One day, he jumped on a train and disappeared from the sight of his family, going to the unknown. He had found himself in the center of the city, not knowing anyone. Ritter had a pretty incredible history. A secret agent for an American government, he had enlisted in spite of himself in this situation. He had discovered his involvement in secret affairs after experiencing troubling events. About 10 years had passed since the plane crash that he had survived. He had experienced a fairly intense post-traumatic shock. He was constantly reviewing images of this event. Ritter was very emotionally disturbed and was looking to get to know each other. Moreover, he was desperately searching for a logical explanation for everything that had happened and was happening. Paper mail had not existed for hundreds of years, email had taken possession of all communications. Ritter noticed that the population was getting sicker and sicker. He was trying to understand this plague that was attacking the planet. His role in secret affairs had not been defined. He had to find his mission. This mission was revealed to him. He rebelled against the secret army. No longer following their rules and no longer obeying their orders, he set off in search of the liberation of mankind, the control and influence that governments and authorities exert over the population. At the dawn of 3117, life was very much like the 2000s, but communications had changed dramatically. The wars between all the countries had wreaked havoc on the whole planet. People divided and countries clashed. People were getting older. It was famine and the people were dying of hunger. Revolutionary movements had tried to change things, but to no avail. In his clandestine laboratory, Ritter continued his quest. He was looking for a cure. He always analyzed in communications, in order to understand a deeper meaning. He discovered that beyond the secrets revealed to him by the agency, the very secret of life was there. Her nights were hectic, tortured with strange dreams that seemed to offer her answers to her questions. With the analysis of his dreams and the secrets of life, he continued his research and his quest. That day, he left his clandestine laboratory to venture outside. The civil wars that were raging put the life of anyone in danger. He made his way to the nearby river. He glimpsed a silhouette in the distance. Bravina had left their home just before him and had gone to the river to contemplate nature. Happy with their unexpected meeting at that moment, they took the opportunity to observe for a moment the fauna around them. He then sat down with her, hand in hand. Without arguing, they fixed their eyes in the eyes. They had left each other only after the breakfast when she had gone outside. He had hardly had time to join her. After that moment, they got up. Ritter took a pebble and threw it into the water. Bravina did the same. She threw her pebble close to the one from which the one from Ritter had landed. The pebbles formed two distinct circles whose waves clashed. A bright idea came to Ritter's mind. At his desk, he began to analyze the circles he had seen in the water. By the time they had thrown those pebbles into the water, Ritter had capped their fate again. He searched for the mathematical formula stating the phenomenon he had witnessed. He discovered a theorem explaining this phenomenon. This theorem revealed more secrecy than a simple mathematical formula. Ritter had discovered what humanity suffered. All the inhabitants of the earth had been contaminated by a destructive virus that affected the human spirit. This virus had been carried by the terrestrial waters, thus affecting the whole planet. This virus was designed to modify the human genetic code. Ritter had discovered the presence of a gene, the connective gene. This gene, designed by the authorities, was intended to connect all living spirits to a central computer. In this way, the authorities could have under surveillance and direct all living consciences. Ritter overstepped the secret laws of the authorities. A universal code that the Earth presented to him. He had just realized that everyone was connected by consciousness. Perhaps he could use this secret technology against himself and use it to deliver the people from the suffering and control of the authorities. The coming of the great evils of the planet had arrived with the coming of the wars and the thirst for power of the leaders. Many of the diseases had been inoculated into the population, and since then the disease has been in a state of flux. Ritter sought a cure for all these ills and came to the conclusion that it is by using this authority-induced technology, the connective gene, to use it wisely. He was going to reach the heart of this central brain, then redistribute the remedy by this same system. He had to change mentalities first. The war would only be a memory, to give way to peace. Every living being should realize that in him he has the fountain of youth and a power of self-healing. To make everyone aware of this reality, he had to make them scared. Ritter appealed to old friends on the revolutionary side. He will create a new community. From it, he would win the hearts of all and make known the power of thought of each. It is said that humans use 10% of their brain. It is a myth. The human being can use all his psychic potential, on the condition of being interested in different subjects, thus stimulating the different areas of the brain. Ritter discovered that the fountain of youth is in itself, in the strength of our spirit. If we think ourselves mortal, we will be. If we believe and we feel alive, we will be alive. Ritter spoke and applied himself to make known knowledge and wisdom to all. However, we ignored him. Nobody wanted to hear what he had to say. Ritter let go and left humanity to his ignorance. Bravina, as for her, trusted Ritter. She took her revelations seriously. In this false and corrupt world, they lived hand in hand. The centuries passed and they saw them pass one by one until the dawn of a new millennium. The population was slowly dying out, people were dying and the earth was changing. Ritter would have liked to open consciences, but he had not succeeded. Only a few people wanted to hear his claims, and this small community was the only one to survive the plagues of this millennium. A handful of men and women lived a millennium before seeing a new land, almost decimated of any population. Those who survived cried the missing. They would have wished for a healthy land and peace for all, but humanity being deaf, they ran to their own loss. Ritter and Bravina had seen the centuries pass. Their skins had barely taken a few wrinkles. They would see, metaphorically, again the sun rise over humanity. Every living being had become aware of the importance of consciousness and the power of it. The new generation that announces itself would be awake. The great evils formerly known were overstepped. Health and peace was now on the agenda. Ritter and Bravina had discovered the greatest secret of the earth. Be self-confident. Use all your psychic potential. The fountain of youth is in us. The two lovers, who had loved each other deeply for 1,000 years, did not see the end. They would continue to love each other forever, forever.